Hey everybody, welcome back to Better Computer. My name is Matt, and today we're going to be taking a look at Cron, which has a bunch of things that I think are really cool and make it a really compelling calendar app. Now, a couple caveats about Cron. One, it's in early access, so you can request access right now, but you can't just necessarily download it right away and start using it. It's totally free right now. Cron is actually owned by Notion, so they acquired Cron a year or so ago. Anyway, it's free, just you have to request access, and hopefully you'll get in pretty soon. The second caveat is it only works with Google calendars. If you're using Outlook, iCloud, or anything else, it's not going to work with those, but you can connect as many Google accounts to it as you'd like. And so, yeah, if that works for you, you can totally do it. Works on iOS, macOS, and Windows. The iOS app isn't so hot, but the macOS and Windows ones are really great. Also, there is a web app, so you can go to the web app and just load it totally on the web. We're not going to show that, but it's exactly the same because it is an Electron app. But the first thing I want to mention that I really like about Cron is that Cron is, despite being an Electron app and the reputation that comes along with that, it is super fast to interact with. Everything is quick. Everything is reliable and syncs incredibly quickly with the web. I never get into issues where my calendar in Cron is out of sync with what's actually on my Google account. It's really perfect, really fantastic there, and the most reliable and quickest syncing I've ever had with a non-native calendar app. So not Google Calendar itself, but using some app to connect to it. It's so fast, so easy to use. So that's the first thing. Just reliability for me is super, super important, and Cron is excellent there. Next, let's talk about availability, and this is a really huge thing. So I find myself wanting to schedule meetings with someone, but I want to let them choose when to meet with me. And there's services like Calendly that do this. Fantastical has their openings feature, but Cron has this built in as well, so you can just share your availability very quickly. So when I click that, it's going to start a meeting, and I can like kind of drag over the thing. So let's say next week is when I want to do it, and let's say I can do 8 a.m. to 11 on Monday. My Tuesday is pretty wide open, so whenever they want. Wednesday is packed, so let's not do anything there. All day there, and then let's just do a couple hours on Thursday. So those are the times that are available for people to schedule things. I can rename this to whatever I want. I can choose to have Google Meet or Zoom there. This is a default setting in the app settings. You can choose what to automatically add or not if you want. I can tweak the things here, or I can just kind of drag and drop. But let's just say, let's create this as availability. And here's the thing that they want me to send. I can copy to my clipboard, but let's just copy the link and open our browser and go here. And when I send this to somebody to say, hey, click this link to schedule something with me, you can see the availability Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday of next week. No Wednesday, because we didn't do that. All the times are here. They can choose the time they want. They can enter their email to decide what calendar to put it on, and then we'll kind of get linked up and schedule the meeting. And this is really just awesome to have built into Cron. I don't have to pay for an extra thing or an extra service. It's just kind of built in. And again, Cron is totally free for now. I don't know if it'll stay that way forever, but as of right now, it's a totally free way to let someone schedule time with you. I've used it in the real life and it works great. So I'm a really big fan of having that built in to Cron. Another thing I really like is being able to schedule meetings with someone else very quickly. So let's say meet with, and then I can search, but I actually already selected this person for me, which is me. And I'm on next week. And if they had availability that wasn't available, it would gray it out kind of with these stripes here, like it's showing. But they're pretty wide open. So let's just say Tuesday for 30 minutes, drag and drop. There we go. Send the invite and boom, it's done. Again, my settings in the app, which you can go into here. You can choose to automatically add, let's see, conferencing. So I have it set to automatically add Google Meet, but you can also connect your Zoom account or say no conferencing. But I have it set to Google Meet because that's what I use for work. But anyway, easy to set meeting up with a specific person very quickly and see their availability in line on your calendar. So let's get rid of that, move on to the next thing. Another thing I really, really love is the menu bar icon. So if I go back to today, you can see I have this video recording item that starts in a couple minutes. And if I go up to the menu bar, you can see video recording in 3 minutes. So awesome to just let my calendar be in the background and just be able to glance up at the top right of my screen and see what meetings are coming up. When the meeting actually happens, there'll be a notification, of course, but like I can just keep an eye of what's happening. I can join the Google Meet from here. I can see what's on my schedule coming up. But just being able to look up at the top right briefly and see I have this thing in a few minutes, it'd be kind of cool if they could color code it a little bit, make it red maybe a couple minutes before it starts or something like that. But That's really rad. If I move this actually, so there's nothing in the immediate future, this actually just changes to the date. It would be kind of nice if the date would always be visible, because now I don't know it's the 21st. Anyway, that's a nitpick, but it is a really nice thing to just be able to see this thing up here at all times and know what meeting is coming up. Another thing that's really awesome are notifications, and I can't show this live because the way I record my screen actually suppresses notifications, but at the moment a meeting starts, or a minute before, 2 minutes before, 10 minutes before, whatever you want, you can configure it in the app settings, a really nice notification, a custom notification will come up that will have a button you can click to join the meeting instantly if it has a video call associated with it. So I really love that. Again, not much to show here, but it doesn't use the system notifications. You can use system notifications if you want. I choose to use their native ones because, or not their native ones, their non-native ones, because they're easier to join meetings. Okay, and now let's talk keyboard shortcuts, because keyboard shortcuts are awesome and they're here for basically everything. If you want to browse for what's available, you can hit Command K to bring up the command palette and just browse through what's available, or you can just search for things to find what's there. Let me show you a couple that are really cool. So share availability, you can just hit S to bring up that interface. We looked at that previously. You don't have to click the button, you can just hit S. For starting a quick meeting, hit F for that to find somebody and kind of schedule that for them. If you want to create an event, hit C, and that's going to create the event, kind of like Google shortcuts. There you go, kind of tab through, arrow through durations and everything. So cool, that works. You can also look at different time zones. So if I'm looking at someone in the UK and I want to schedule something with them, I can hit Z and British summertime. Cool. So now I have my time over here and then GMT plus one right there. I can hit Z again to change it to Pacific, or again, whatever I'd like. But that's really cool to be able to do there. And then to join a meeting, so let's say there's a Google Meet on my next event. What I can do is just while the app is open, hit Command J to open my browser to Google Meet and have it kind of do its thing. Also, if the app is not in the foreground, there's actually a system-wide keyboard shortcut of Command-Control-J, and that's going to do the exact same thing. So if you're working on something in a totally different app and you're just like, oh shoot, I have a meeting right now I need to get into right away, you can just hit Control-Command-J, and you're going to join it from wherever you are right away, so that's really awesome. So tons and tons of shortcuts, basically for everything you can imagine. So take a look, browse once you're into the app, but those are some of the cool things that I use on a regular basis. Okay, and finally, this one is kind of a huge one for me as someone who schedules a ton of meetings with other people and needs to change them sometimes. Maybe I change the description, maybe I change the time of them. And one of the things I don't like about Fantastical is it doesn't tell me what notifications went out when I make a change, right? Or whether I can control whether a notification goes out. So I have this meeting right here. It's an interview with myself. But basically I want to move this to later in the day. So I'm just going to drag it to the new time that I want. So we'll do it at 1 o'clock. And it's gonna give me this pop-up that asks me if I want to send the update. So I can discard the change, I can keep making changes, or I can send the update or send an update without emailing the other person. I want them to know about the time change, so let me send the update. I was very explicit about what I was doing, and I get this little notification down here that says, hey, the update was sent and it was sent to this person. So that's cool. If I want to change the description, maybe this one, I don't need to send an email. I could just change the description, who cares? Send update without email. And in this case, we see a notification that says event updated. It was updated for Matt without sending an email notification. And just this clarity around what's happening. As someone who uses calendars for my professional work all the time, it's really, really nice to have that just in the interface and make it very clear what's happening. So yeah, that is Cron. I don't know if it's going to be my forever calendar, but it's what I'm using right now to just kind of see what I appreciate about it. And I really think it's pretty great. I do think it's unfortunate it's in early access right now and you can't just download it and start using it. I do think it's unfortunate it only works with Google accounts, but if those are okay for you, if you're able to get access to the thing and you're already using Google accounts and it'll work with you, that's excellent. But yeah, I really, really think this is a up-and-coming calendar app. I try a ton of calendar apps and I rarely make videos about them because they all kind of suck. Outside of Fantastical, Cron is the first one that's really grabbed my attention and does some things that I really like. So hopefully this video was helpful. If it was, drop a like down below and I'll see you here next time. Bye-bye.